Nazeem Richardson is a brilliant boxing trainer who works with such stars as Bernard Hopkins and Sugar Shane Mosley. And it was, in fact, moments before Sugar Shane Mosley beat Antonio Margarito at the Staples Center for the championship that Nazeem realized that Margarito was cheating. No one ever discovered this before. I caught up with Richardson to ask him about that moment that he noticed that Margarito was packing more in his gloves than just tape and fists.
How did you find out that Margarito was cheating? Because nobody ever discovered it until you came around.
I raised a lot of my sons and my nephews in boxing. So you still had that parental thing that you know, a lot of times Shane and Bernard are like, come on, man. You know, because you find yourself on them. So you're watching everything because you're overprotective as a parent. And I'm watching them rap, and I just saw the cushion on the table, and I picked it up to check it. And the thing was hard. I told the guy, I said, man, this really got deputy commissioner said, feels all right to me. I said, well, don't feel all right to me. And I mean, the commissioner felt it. The commissioner said, no, that feels pretty hard. And they opened up, and that block fell out, and I almost messed up the whole fight. Because I'm a street guy, dude. As soon as that block fell out, I was about to come across the table, punch that dude in his mouth. Then the story would have been about, when I said, are you still going to court for fighting this whole thing? That would have been an issue. Then I thought I threw the fight off, because I thought they was going to lock him up. I sat down and told the guy next to him, I said, he going to jail for that. I said, which I thought he was. That's why I wouldn't release the blocks and nobody could have changed more.
But no one ever thought about it. No one thinks that boxers cheat anymore. That's old school stuff.
But things you see, certain things you can watch a fight and things look peculiar to you. You see a guy throwing shots, hitting guys on the top of the cranium, hitting guys on the elbow, hitting guys in the hands and never hurting. Doing that. Because every fighter, we teach our fighters, hit a guy in that cranium and mess his hand up. Okay, how you wrap that? You see a guy can just come in and just punch anywhere. That's strange to me, man. I mean, there's George Foreman's out there and Sonny Liston's. We know there's gifted punches out there. But damn, I mean, yeah, George Foreman hit an elbow or something. He's still throwing stuff at Cotto. But see, my worry with Margarito wasn't his punching ability. You can't train for a man's chin. Now, I thought Shane could hurt Margarito, but I couldn't take it for granted in the camp. I couldn't say, well, we're going to knock him off. I told Shane, I said, in the 11th round, we do everything we're supposed to do, Shane. In the 11th round, this guy may still be coming at us like Ray Lewis off the Baltimore damn Ray. I just joke, he punches like they're Skittles. You know what I mean? So we can't train for his chin. I can't just be arrogant to say Shane punched so hard, he gonna hurt this guy's chin. I ain't seen nothing. Nobody else hurt his chin. I seen Cotto hit this joker with everything in the book. And this joker's not blinking. I seen Joshua Cloudy hit this joker with the jaw. So now, if anything, I like to inspect this joker's jaw. Damn his hand. I like to inspect his jaw.
Shane talks very highly of you as a trainer. What's your secret of success?
I've been blessed, man. I've been blessed that the technical side, one is I got a respect for the sport. I think, I said it in an interview we just did not too long ago. I told him, I said, you never hear George call mouthing another coach in the NBA, even after they done blew him out with your third stringer. We're the only sport that, and what it is, most of us as coaches were fighters. And what happens sometimes is that old fighter want a limelight come out, and we try to overshadow the doggone fighter. I'm the greatest I've ever been. That's fine. We heard you. You're the greatest. Okay. Now, it's like your children. You don't tell your children every 5 minutes that it's time for bed. Something's got to go. After I said it once or twice, it's time for bed. I think I got to keep saying it. There's something wrong with the scenario. You know what I mean? So I never understood where the trainers are bad mouthing each other. He can't coach. I respect the sport. I find a common ground to stand with every coach. If nothing else, they got a young kid off the street that could be on the street. I got to respect him on that. If nothing else, I mean, I like nothing he does as far as the way he plays basketball. And I just learned that works for me. Because I don't see my guy and say, he can punch. We can punch too. I see my guy say, he can punch. I got a young son named Bear. One of the smartest fighters I've ever seen, my youngest son. Probably because he's a coach's kid. He's boxing his kid named Philadelphia that can punch. I mean, this kid can really punch. I said, Bear, I'm going to put you in there with this kid. This kid can really, really punch. All right? He said, all right, Bob. So him and Bear went a couple rounds. So he came to the corner. After he came to the corner, a couple of guys asked me, say, Bear, hey, can I lob a punch? He said, I don't know. I didn't let him hit me. So my father told me he could punch. I just didn't let him hit me. So with respect, you can make a better athlete. Going in there just thinking, hey, look, I'm the greatest. I'm going to go ahead and listen, man. We all got work to do. I'm learning. I'm watching tape. I watch these kids in the gym. I tell him, I say, your job is to be the third sugar. It was Sugar Shane Robinson, it was Sugar Ray Leonard, and now it's Sugar Shane Moses. You the third sugar. I say, stack the deck high. I said, because we got a young kid in our gym named Sugar Shane. I said, he on your ass. I said, he's about 9 years old, 10 years old. This little kid is something else, but he's a special kid. And there'll be some more to come along, you know what I mean? And it's time, it's folks, you know?
Brother Nazim Richardson and Mosley will unite once again January 30th in the same corners. They're going to face Andre Berto. The fight will happen at the Mandalay Bay in Vegas. In Los Angeles, I'm Elise Ekback, reporting.